before, I'd like to say a couple of words about our conference because it is some kind of just innovative format, if I may put it so, because just it is the first time we are going to do it. Well, and why have we decided to give this format a go? Because really we want to be just innovative, we want to push boundaries, and I think that it's really significant for us today. Well, and to my mind, it's really important for you because you are young, and of course it is your just priority to push boundaries, to make something new. Well, and what is going to be here? So we're going to listen to three conversations, right? Each conversation will consist of three parts: the introduction, debates, and the conclusion. Well, the conversations will be devoted to different topics today. First of all, it will be why we go to space, then international clashes and the influence on mass media, and also space debris. And we cannot deny the importance of these topics today, and we cannot underestimate them. So that's why we have decided to raise these questions today. Well, these conversations will last about 15, 20 minutes. Then, guys, I really want you to be a part of this conference. And it's really significant for us to just see you as a participant of our conference. That's why after each conversation, you are allowed to ask questions. Maria Alexandra, you are going to be here. I haven't seen you. So you will be our member of the jury. Thank you so much for your coming. We are waiting.
Start with the first milestone. I think to be the first man in space, also the first flight to the moon, and also flights and international programs also.
Okay, see, Jan, are you in the same position?
So I absolutely agree with Lip, and I want to say that for me, milestone of space exploration was the first day when men saw the first planet. And that time they understand they are not alone in this galaxy, and that our planet is based not on three whales. And we understand in what big area we live.
Yes, sure. And to make our topic crystal clear, of course we should define what space is for us. I think that quite many people think about space some kind of a vacuum place, or it is some vast territory. So everyone has their own perception of space. So what about you, Luke? What space is for you?
Well, that's right. For me, it is endless darkness and silence. I hope that we can explore space much better, but it's a matter of time. And of course, we need right scientists, technologists, and brave people who go in space.
Thank you. Jan, what's your impression?
I would say that for me, galaxy is something dark, gloomy. Of course, it's planets, different stars, but also I want to say when I was young, I saw a beautiful picture about space and where I saw different planets. And after it, when I listen to the word space, I think about this picture.
Yes, that's right, because from the childhood we can just understand what space is for us and so on. Well, and of course, space goes together with astronauts, people who just make research there. And one astronaut was asked why it was so important to go to space. And the answer was mind-boggling. It was really simple. And it is the quotation, "We simply must go there." Is it really true that we must go there? It is our duty, our obsession in some respects. Oh, well, and do human beings have any future in space? Because I'm dubious about this fact, because we haven't gone farther than the moon. Luke, what's your opinion?
Well, I should start with the fact that we know that renewable resources slowly refill, and also non-renewable resources we cannot refill. So also the fact that we have overpopulation on the Earth, that's why I think that we do need to go to space.
Yes, so we have vital problems, right? Yeah. Burning problems, and that's why it's some sort of solving our problems. Jan, what is your view?
So my point of view, I think, of course, we should explore Moon and other planets like our renewable resources. Yeah, and of course, sometimes we can live in other planets like Moon or Mars or something like that. But of course, we shouldn't forget about different factors which can be dangerous for our humanity, like different illness or ailments, something like that. And we haven't got different weapons for this. Sometimes we haven't got an answer to our questions.
Yes, that's interesting. And it is a common fact that space exploration is time-consuming and, of course, money-consuming, right? And who should be in charge of funding for space exploration? Should it be commercial or non-commercial organizations? Because some people say that probably space exploration is like a black hole. You just invest so much money there. Should commercial organizations be responsible for space exploration? Luke, what's your impression?
I think if they can, of course, why not? Of course, it's not a secret that all space explorations cost much money, and this duty can solve only the government. But if the commercial organization can achieve the results in space exploration, why not? We can spend the money.
Yes,
I see your point. Yeah, what's your reaction?
So I think non-government organizations think only about instantaneous profit, and because of it, they don't want to spend their money for science, but they should understand how important for them, and also important for all government. And I think they, the government and a non-profit organization should work together, and only after that they should think about space exploration. Because of course, government can't spend a lot of money of the budget to the space exploration. It may be about 5 or 3%.
Okay, or even just less. Yes. I think that space exploration and quick money, yes, they do not go together absolutely. Well, speaking about technologies that were brought because of space exploration, so do they have practice value? And probably you have some examples of those technologies. Luke.
Well, many people prefer spending their holidays snowboarding or skiing, and I know that their clothes are made from the same material as astronauts have. So also the special sunglasses, mm-hmm. Yes, we have on the Earth. It was surprising for me. I read that first food for children, I mean porridge and some mm-hmm. examples, they have the same construction as astronauts have. So I think that almost everyone of us starts their life as an astronaut.
Yes, that's great. Great point. Jan, anything to add?
Yeah, as I remember, the water system, filtration system, which we use every day, also is a result of astronauts program. Also, the software computer program where you could find and save your different information, maybe about business information or something like that. In many companies, you can see that. Also, in 1960s, was invented the computer to exchange images of the moon, and nowadays it's very useful to exchange images of organs of humans. It's about magnetic resonance imaging and something like that. Of course, it's very important.
Yes, that's magnificent. Yes, that's right. So, but nevertheless, space exploration and going to space isn't an easy stroll, I should say. So, and we know so many just casualties. We know about so many casualties, right? 5 people were killed in the Soviet Union and 14 people were killed because of shuttle catastrophes. So I think that it must be taken into account, really. So probably it's high time we banned human missions and switched over to unmanned missions, robot missions. So what's your impression, Luke, in this case?
Well, despite all negative sides, I think that here we have a very tough competition between people who really want to go into outer space. And the first aim is to find a place for future generations. So I think that we do not need robots for this. And I should say that spaceman is a very respectful profession, so they represent their country, and their names are written in the history, so why not?
Yes, that's great, right? But there are so many pitfalls. Are you in the same position?
Yes, the same opinion, but I want to raise that, of course, in their own opinion, in their own choice, but don't forget it's very expensive, it's very harmful. But we should understand how it's important for human physiological
state.
Yeah, and for body, right?
Yes.
Without it, we can't understand. But also, we should think about robots, maybe it should represent humanity in space.
Uh-huh. And probably, do you believe in Mars missions? So,
is it feasible to realize, just to establish human colonies on Mars? Luke, what's your opinion?
Well, again, I should say that these people make their own conscious choice, so if they want, we should let them go to space.
So does it mean that we shouldn't just look for reasons, for logical reasons, why we go to space? So sometimes it's really emotional for us, right?
Yes, I agree with your words.
Okay,
I mean, it's silly sometimes because they will live without their family. They have got homes or they haven't got friends and something like that. And they don't know where they could live, what they would eat, and what is it? What the space should be for them?
Yes, and of course for Mars missions it is one-way ticket, they will never return. So, and for me it's like crazy people going to space as to colonize the new planet. Well, and is it a prestige factor really? For today we have the Russian Federation, the United States, Japan, the European Union, so all these nations are in race. And India and China would like to have their own say in this case. So for what purpose? So do they, will they have their own say in this space exploration? Yeah.
So I think, first of all, they should think about their economic system because they have a lot of problems in the Earth. And they shouldn't think about space exploration because they want to think, oh yeah, it's really cool, it's something like United States of America, but they have a lot of problems and they should think about the people in the Earth.
Mm-hmm. What do you agree with this?
Well, I can agree with Jana and also add some words that these countries have all needed resources and we shouldn't expend them from this race. And I should remind that space exploration unites countries and we can let them.
Yes, it must be an international business, right, in other words. So, and as I said at the beginning, so Americans are mostly, they are against space exploration. Well, girls, I will give you 30 seconds to make your own speech to change their minds. So, Luke, let's start with you.
Well, first of all, I should admit that, and start with the English thing that every stick has two ends, and of course, we can say about the space explorations. Every time we go into outer space, we prove or disprove the theory, and nowadays the level of space exploration progress achieved the level when almost everyone can go into space. And we know that space explorations bring a huge contribution to our everyday life, and let's turn our science fiction films into reality and continue going into space.
Perfect. Yeah.
So I want to start with a question, and about human opinion that don't troubles as in troubles you. I want to change your opinion and said don't delinquent in the new part of our history. Because how often do you think about space exploration? Well, you don't. Astronauts at the same moment make research with the same place. Because space is our new home after war and catastrophes. Don't blame your government, they spend too much money of your budget to space exploration. It's only about 5%. But other countries really prepared to work together because it really connects us. But you should forget about aliens. It's only primitive life. So this unexplored part of a galaxy should be our gift for future generation.
Okay, that's great. Thank you so much for the discussion, and I will make.
Guys, if you have questions, your comments, your views, please just.
I've got a question.
Right.
Okay, what do you think about programming when people fly to the cosmos, when just ordinary people fly to the cosmos? What do you think about it, and would you like to try it?
So, I think they haven't got important knowledge for this trip. And they should understand how important it is, and it's not so easy. It's not so... first of all, it's very expensive, and think about your body. Think about physical part of your body.
Yes.
Do you really want to go to space?
Right. So you should be a little bit strong, right? Probably there are some kind of technologies. Yes. Luke, do you think the same way?
As I said, that the progress achieved the level when almost everyone can go out of space, yes. For me, honestly, I'm afraid of the space, the darkness and silence. So, not me, but maybe my children or grandchildren can.
And you, would you like to go to space to make this trip come true?
I don't know, I'm afraid of this.
Yes, we all are.
Really. No, but I think it's a good idea for ordinary people to go to space because we know that nobody of us maybe can go to space. But when you believe that you can do it,
yes.
It's better.
If it is safe, then it's a good idea, right?
Yes.
But you should have some guarantees, right? If you do not have them, so there's no way, right? Uh-huh. Any other questions, comments, guys? Impressions. So, have we changed your opinion about space? No. So, who was against space exploration? Yeah. So, what about you? So, express your opinion. So, why are you against it?
Well, I think it is not very good idea to go to space because we have said that we must think about our body, about ourselves. I think we live in our world. We should live how we want, and we don't need to
limit ourselves.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. That's great. Yes. I think that especially for young people, it's just a good opportunity to make themselves brighter, right, and to build their career. So why not? Why not? Okay. And you also were against. Yeah, space exploration probably. Mm. Have you changed your mind after this topic, after this conversation? Have we persuaded you? Really? Yes? No? Yes. Okay, I see. So, any other comments, guys? No? Not really? Thank you so much. Thank you so much for this, right, for this conversation. Go. And I think that we will make a musical pause right now. Guys, you're welcome.
Change my mind, I've opened up the doors. Help me if you can, I'm feeling down. And I do appreciate you being around. Help me get my feet back on the ground. Won't you please, please help me? Changing not so many ways. My independence seems to vanish in the haze. But every now and then I feel so insecure. I'm not enough that I just need you like I've never done before. Help me if you can, I'm feeling down. And I do appreciate you being round. Help me get my feet back on the ground. Won't you please, please help me? When I was younger, so much younger than today, I never needed anybody's help in any way. But now these days are gone, I'm not so self-assured. Never fun, I've changed my mind, I've opened up the doors. Help me if you can, I'm feeling down. And I do appreciate you being round. my feet back on the ground. Won't you please, please help me, help me, help me.
About the influence of mass media and the influence of modern conflicts on mass media, the Russian mass media. As you know, I'm a student of Moscow Aviation Institute, like everybody here, and about mass media. We have a lot of types in Russia. It's like television, and ask me, answer please my question, who, when you come home, switch on the TV, just for fun? And who watch you turn on your TV in the evening, for example, to watch news? Just two persons?
Four.
Four? Okay. And it's not so popular today because we know there are a lot of bad news on TV, and it's difficult to know about it, and for us it's easier to live and don't know about the situation in the world. We have newspapers, for example, when you go to university in the morning, you can take a free newspaper like Metro. In Metro, who takes it? Nobody. One girl. Yes. Nobody read newspapers. Okay. And about internet. Who takes your phone to check out what's happened in our world? Who turns on Twitter? More people. Okay. And nobody other. No. You don't like to know what's happened in our world. Okay. Doesn't matter. And about the internet, about, for example, Twitter, when you can read all news for free, and it's so young thing for Russia, especially, because it starts maybe 6 years ago. We have portals like Live News in the internet, we have we have it, and it's a very important part of our life. And now I want to give some give 10 minutes for my group mates, and they will tell the situation with mass media in Russia. First, Alexei, please.
You know, Anton said right now that we have a lot of problems, bad news in mass media, so I would like to speak with you about one of them. I would like to speak with you about sanctions. All of you know that a few years ago, actually 2 years ago, Western countries imposed political sanctions against Russia. There is no doubt that it has affected on our economy. By the way, mass media has concentrated our attention to this topic. And by the way, sanctions are all over the headlines nowadays too. It's a very important problem, and you know, every evening I watch news and I noticed to myself such a thing that the word import replacement has become very popular. So what does it mean, import replacement? To my mind, it's great when a country can do a lot of goods by itself, but you know, I think that the meaning of import replacement in mass media is too exaggerated, because I think that they're trying to tell us that we can survive without any other goods, without any foreign help, and etc. But just take a look what's going on with the prices in shops, in the malls. I mean, the inflation is huge nowadays. The wages are falling down every year. I mean, it's going harder and harder every day to survive. I understand that all of you has your own opinion to this problem, and I just tell you my thoughts, and I just tell you what I think. But this is, but I understand that it's big, it's a huge problem, and I hope that Western sanctions will end in the nearest future.
Okay, it's a very interesting opinion, Alexei, and now I'll give some minutes, a few minutes for Diana or Michael, and now your turn.
Thank you, Tony. I would like to discuss the interference between mass media and international relationships. So I would like to start with the fact that television brought us not only a new way of transmitting information, but it's also reflected on implementations of political activity. So television has a great influence on masses. That's why a lot of politicians use it. And they take it into account its power. More than that, mass media, according to many experts, became the fourth branch of power, as opposed to the three traditional ones. It has the specific mechanism of influence and their own features. So the most important thing that mass media influence extend not only in one country, but in other countries too. So people can watch news, TV, or as you say, newspapers, read newspapers, and make their own decisions. But sometimes, mass media cause negative repercussions, so we should be clear when you read something or watch TV. Thereby, we can absolutely confirm that today mass media interact with policy, and it can stimulate international problems, or it can help us, and it can give an impulse to a generation of conditional relationships between countries.
Okay, it's your opinion, and it's very important to know the truth, and it's very important to know who lies. Then, Diana, your turn.
Well, there are so many problems in the modern world, such as global warming, environmental issues, shortage of natural resources, earthquakes, floods, and other disasters. But one of the most dangerous of all is terrorism. It is a huge threat to all mankind. Today we hear more and more news on TV about terroristic attacks. All magazines and newspapers write about this problem. Each year, different countries face terrorism. A lot of people suffer from terroristic acts. Some die, some get wounded, others lose their loved ones. In certain countries, people are even scared to go to the cinemas, theaters, concerts, supermarkets, and other crowded places. I think that people who become terrorists have no values in life. Most attacks take place because of misunderstanding. While some countries are in war between each other, the civilians suffer. Terrorism also occurs on basis of religious matters. It is especially very sad when children become the targets of terrorists. For example, it was a very big attack in the south part of Russia, in Beslan, when it was a terrible tragedy for the family and for all country. Another unexpected attack
took place in Paris in November 2015. A series of terroristic attacks shocked all French population and as well all people in the world. The number of dead people exceeded 150. Among them, there were also people from other countries. I think that terrorism is not just a problem, it is a global disaster, and we should unite and confront it together.
That's true. We're afraid about this problem about terrorism because when you go to the nearest metro station, you don't know what will happen after 10 minutes. And the last opinion, it's Nikolai, your turn, and tell us what do you think about mass media in Russia and its problems.
Yes, thank you. Hello. I'd like to tell about the differences in the presentation of information in Russia and other countries by mass media. Mass media often is a source of important news, from which I can conclude that mass media shows the situation in the world to the people who cannot see the situation. Mass media shapes people's understanding about the situation in the world, and almost everyone believes. And I think that it's excellent opportunity to government to form the people's mind about the situation in the world. And in the conclusion, I want to say, things happen, and let us hope for the best. And of course, use your brains. Let's hope.
Thank you, Nikolai, for your opinion. It's quite difficult for understanding because it's true. And now we have some time for questions, and you can ask us about our topic. I really don't watch TV because I have no time for TV, and but from time to time I like to switch it.
I do. I watch TV, but not news.
I use I read newspapers. I use Vkontakte to read news because I think it's stupid, but I do. And as I know, internet is a new thing in Russia. Popular things like live news, like Vkontakte, but 6.5% of modern news providers, it's Russian providers, and it's very high level. Okay.
What can you say about the channel Russia Today? Do you know this channel, and have you ever read their news and their shows? I think that the situation is not so bad as you say in your speech.
My gosh.
Yes, you can.
Well, of course, I know the channel Russia Today, but I don't know if you know, the owner of Russia Today is Russian.
Yeah, of course, Russia Today, yeah.
So they use, again, the government's opinion, but they are trying to tell this opinion to the Western citizens.
I also know that they have interviews and discusses with the leaders from foreign countries and people who represent other countries, so we should not believe them or what. I think that what is shown on Russia Today is very honest and fresh information. So, of course, it is not like the first channel here in Russia. And I know that many foreign people prefer this channel and they believe this information. So maybe not so bad as you said.
We didn't say that it's bad.
Yes, we didn't say that it's bad, but Russia Today is like the first channel, it's like the government channel at all.
Yeah. But
so, I didn't see a big difference between Russia Today, between Life News, between First Channel. I think, to my mind, they ignore like the bad information, the bad situation, the economy, and they like, you know, they filter news, what to say to the citizens.
But maybe sometimes they want to also to protect you.
No, yes, it's for protection.
Yes, I said that maybe it's just because not to raise the panic around the people, you know, who knows, but maybe it's true, maybe it's right.
And from time to time they show news to show you that you are not in dream, because when you watch TV and it's always good news and everything is right and it's stupid. And Russia Today shows us some music that are true, but they are just... Yes, you are understood. Okay, in conclusion, I need to say that we are here not to show you whom to believe. We are here to tell our opinion on this problem, as we said. And we are here to show that you need to think and filter the information from newspapers, from TV sets, from television, doesn't matter, from internet and radio. And thanks, thank you, and
for your
it's
attention.
Over.
It's over.
Very serious conversation, and to make the atmosphere more relaxed, we will sing the song, the one by John Cash.
Yeah.